maybe you're struggling in a class, the professor doesn't think you're working as hard as you can or giving the kind of effort that you know you are and maybe that you are. And that little gap of misunderstanding happens, and then your grade suffers because of it. I can tell you now, the professor's not gonna suffer. They're gonna go through the list of people and they're gonna have little mental thoughts. The more that you're in their head, in their face, communicating with them, the more they're gonna remember you and either give you that little break and that better grade, or they're gonna round it down, okay? And for you to be able to go in and communicate certain things, in college, you might have adversities. You might have somebody in your family die where you can't be focused, or somebody that needs you for a certain reason, or you get injured, or you just, I don't know, maybe you're growing on the inside and you need a little space and time for yourself. But college, there's never a good time to do that. Okay, so if I can communicate properly, it usually allows me to get what I want a lot more efficiently, a lot easier, even though the communication took a lot of work and a lot of effort and a lot of courage, and I had to exercise my vulnerability. Your ability to communicate, and the more you do it, you're gonna feel competent in it. When you feel competent in it, you will be more confident. That will build to your confidence of being able to properly and efficiently communicate at the levels that you will need to.